Hey everyone, Sir Gentleman here. We're back with another Call to Arms Gates Hell-Ostfront tutorial, and this time we're talking AT guns. So I'll just run down what we're going to go through in this video. We're going to go through obviously the penetration of all the guns, their inventories, and how effective I feel that they are. This is my opinion as well, so feel free to tell me your opinion on each gun and if they're worth the actual price, because obviously smaller guns are cheaper and easier to get into your deployment on Conquest, and obviously bigger guns take up more points. We have the German weapons, the Russian, and the Finnish. So we'll split this video into timestamps so you can switch to whichever faction you prefer. Anyway, we'll start with the Germans, and we'll start with the 2.8 centimeter. Now, this small little gun here was developed a bit later in the war. It only uses armor-piercing composite-rated and high-explosive rounds. That's why such a small weapon can have such high penetration. It has 102 millimeter max penetration, and it goes down to 86, 66, and 44. The damage drop-off is massive because small caliber rounds. So that means when you're firing at things like a T-34, even though you have the high penetration at the start, because of its massive damage drop-off, it means it is not that effective at range, which is a bit of a problem with it being an AT gun. It's definitely useful on the more up close if you want to bring it in like urban environments where you can put it on the choke point. Now it does have a pretty good fire rate. But yeah, it's a bit of a weird one. It was developed a bit independently. Now there is a half track on with this as well. It's in a different part of the research chart as well. It's up near the command squad area, where the ATs, some of the like Shreks and Panzerfausts are as well. So, gives you a different option, but in my opinion, it's not really worth it. It's something fun to have, but it's definitely not reliable AT. Next, we have the 37mm pack, aka the door knocker, as it was called in the war. Fast fire rate, as you can see, it can knock out rounds pretty quick. It's not very powerful. Has penetration of 52mm. Then 46, 40, and 31. Obviously, I just forgot to go through ranges. Range of this is 160 meters max. This is also 160 meters max. It's not particularly effective. It does have a fast fire rate, but it's only going to be dealing with light armor. Mediums may be very close, like within 30 meters on the sides, but it won't do anything to medium armor. But it does have quite fast fire rate. It does have armor-piercing composite rigid rounds to increase its power, but it's your first AT gun that's already unlocked, so it's not particularly useful. Only bring it if you really need it. Next is the 4.7 centimeter pack. I believe the range is also 160 on it. Oh, just shy of one, so it's 170, just to 170. Comes armor piercing high explosives. Now it has pretty good fire rate still, as you can see. Reloads quite quick. It's got 92 millimeters penetration max, then 82, 69, then 54. I quite like the 4.7 centimeter. It's the same gun that's on the Jagdpanzer, the first tank hunter you can get. And it's not a bad little weapon, but still, it isn't going to be dealing with medium tanks that effectively. Now, it can penetrate the turret if you hit, but it's not the most accurate at range either, being that it's a kind of smaller weapon. But you can penetrate the turret on things like a T-34, the base version, but it won't penetrate the front armour. Oh, it just did clip the turret there, though, but it doesn't have the actual penetration. So it does for certain areas, but not other bits. So if you hit, for instance, around there on the hull, it's just going to ding. It's not a bad little weapon, decent reload speed, but in my opinion, another one to miss unless you desperately need it. Better to bring the Panzerjäger because it's got more mobility. Next is the 5 centimeter pack. Now this is where the guns really upgrade. This thing also has a range of, can't remember all the ranges off by heart. It's got a range just shy of 180. It comes with armor piercing, high explosive, armor piercing, composite rigid. Its penetration is 102 millimeters max, then 92. Then 79, then 64. So it is quite powerful, and it will take on a T-34 frontally. It can penetrate certain spots, not all of them, because the T-34 is a fairly tough cookie, but you can get into a T-34 and do some damage. Decent fire rate, as you can see, and it can pound away. Better to use the composite rigid on the front of the T-34, but it can get through the sides as well. It's kind of your first decent anti-tank gun. I quite like these. It's also the same gun that ends up being put on the, or the similar variant gets put on the Panda 3 when it gets upgraded. So yeah, pretty good gun. Next we have the medium AT 7.5 cm pack 9738. Now these were captured French guns and they were low velocity. So the Germans basically just says, right, we'll put high explosives with the tank rounds in them. So that gives it penetration. Now it's a bit weird when I looked at the chart. Its penetration is 88 then 87. Because it's high explosive by the tank, it will be the same penetration whatever range. So it should be 88mm at whatever range. Which is good. It means at further ranges it's still kicking some decent damage, and its range is 170. Now we'll just quickly fire around off, see if it works. And as you can see, 88mm penetration straight into that T-34. So it's quite a powerful gun, and I quite like them. The fact that they're all high explosive anti-tank range means it doesn't matter if you're engaged at 10 meters or 100, which is effective. So it's definitely a weird weapon, but it's quite good. And because it's 7.5 centimeters, it's big high explosive shells as well. So yeah, great little multi-role weapon. And it's, you know, it's like a decent AT weapon, something a bit different. Then we've got the 7.5 centimeter pack 40. This is, I'd say, probably the best German AT weapon overall. It's got good ammunition types, arm piercing, high explosive, composite rigid, and high explosive anti-tank. Its range, I believe, is 180 as well. Oh no, it's 200, so I've got that wrong. Now this has 150mm max pen, then 142, then 133, then 119, but like I said, you've got high explosive anti-tank and armor piercing composite rigid. And the standard shells alone, as you can see, if you hit with it, it's got quite decent reload speed, it's about 7 seconds I believe. So if we get hit, as you can see, straight through. So it's a very powerful gun. I think it's definitely the best German AT weapon. It's decent, fair cost, it takes about 14 to 15 command points, I think, or deployment population points, I guess it'd be. It's got not the best frontal shield, but it will protect the front two guns from small arms. That's the only thing I can really doubt of it. And it's, yeah, it's probably it's the best multi-role AT, in my opinion, and especially the reload speed's pretty good. And it's actually got better penetration than the Stugs and Panzer IV because it's the actual AT gun variant of the 7.5cm. So it didn't have to be, you know, fit into a turret. Nothing had to be, you know, shortened or made smaller. So you get that 150mm max pen, whereas on the Panzer IVs and Stugs, it's 137, I believe. So it's a very good tank, anti-tank gun, should I say. Then obviously there's the Beast, the 8.8cm pack. Now this might be controversial. I'm not the biggest fan of these after using them in Conquest Enhance. Now even though it is a monster, as we can demonstrate, it will destroy pretty much any tank. It's got a pretty slow reload speed for, you know, it is slower, but it's a massive target. Like this thing, if you look, it's colossal. It's, you know, it's huge for the AT guns that shrunk onto the ground, so it's easy target to hit. And I find they always get hit with high explosive. So I prefer to have the 7.5 because of the smaller, kind of smaller frame. Now it is good, but if you need that heavy AT like that, you're better off bringing a Tiger or a King Tiger or a Jag Tiger or something mobile with that kind of gun. In my opinion, if you get to the point where you need that to deal with IS-2s and stuff, you might as well just bring the heavy armor. This thing, in my opinion, is, yeah, it's just too big for an AT gun. I think it just gets sniped too often. I've had too many T-34s. So if you miss a shot with it, you miss, and then, oh, you still ding it, but then it fires back, it blows you to pieces. But it is very powerful, but it comes with armor piercing, high explosive, because when your gun's that big, you don't need composite rigid to be fair. Yeah, but it's also very expensive. So yeah, I think you're better off with the 7.5cm pack, personally. So that's the Germans done. Oh, obviously Rangers, I forgot to say the range. I think it's 210 or is it 20? 220. So it's very far range. That does have that advantage. But in my opinion, just bring the King Tiger or the Elephant or the Jag Tiger. It's far, far better for bringing that gun on. Next we have the Russians, and we'll start with the 37mm light anti-tank gun, and it has a range of 160. Thing is very light. Its penetration rates are, one sec, I'm just going to find it, 47mm max, then 41, 35 and 26. It comes 20 high explosive, 20 armor piercing. It's got a good fire rate. It's only a small light gun. It's not a bad little weapon. It's it won't penetrate much, obviously. It's your kind of your first AT gun you get if you need one. But straight away, I'd say it's a no. Go straight for the 45mm. This is the bane of most German players. 45mm with its range, I believe it's also 160. Yep, just, yeah, 160. And this thing comes with 30 armor piercing, 30 high explosives. Its penetration rates are 63mm max, then 55, then 45 and 36. It's actually a good little gun. It won't deal with much medium armor, but they will deal with light armor quite effectively, and they can damage medium armor, but everyone knows who's versed them. They have a good fire rate and good accuracy. It's a nasty little gun, definitely worth bringing. I do like the 45mm. Now this is the 45mm late, which is a more upgraded variant. It has max penetration of 76mm, then 66mm, then 54, then 41. So it's got more firepower, and it also has composite rigid rounds. It also has a decent fire rate like the other one. If you hit the target, obviously, helps. But it's a very good little gun. And it does have that increased penetration, so it can actually ding medium tanks and do some damage on the weak spots. Great little gun to bring. I'm quite a big fan of that one as well. Then we've got the 57mm Zis, which is absolute beast of an anti-tank gun. This is the same thing you might see on some of the Russian vehicles. It's high velocity. Its range, I believe, is 200, so well done. It's very far ranged. It has max penetration 141 millimeters, then 127, then 111, then 89. It's very powerful. Has only armor piercing, high explosive rounds, but it is a very, very powerful gun. As you can see, it will normally penetrate at those ranges. Let's target that one. As you can see, dinging straight on. But it has very, it does have a bit of damage drop off because it's a smaller caliber, but it should be able to pen these tanks. It's not doing particularly well, but it does have high penetration. If you ever versus this, I've even had them take targets out. So it can be quite nasty. It tends to always kill crew as well, which is a pain in the arse. But it's, yeah, the damage drop off is a bit more at range, but just be wary of these because they are a small little gun. You think, oh, 57 mm, I'm not worried, but they can be quite nasty. Then we've got the 76mm ZIS 3, obviously one of the bigger guns. It has a range of, I believe, 190, so it's quite far ranged. The ZIS 3 has a penetration of 85mm, then 80, then 74, then 66, but also has composite rigid. No, not composite, high explosive magnetic tanks, so obviously it does have quite a lot of power on it. So if you're struggling to penetrate the tank, switch to your high explosive magnetic tanks, and we'll just show you this, because these things are quite good at smashing things. And they see, did some really good damage there. So it's actually a fair priced gun. I think the 76 guns are really good for the Russians, and they tend to, like you say, that round kind of lobbed. They also used to use these as field guns in the war, I believe, as well, so it's a good gun. Then we have the 76mm F-22, which has 85mm pen, then 78, then 71, then 63. So it's a bit weaker than the ZIS, but it's still a pretty decent anti-tank gun, and it has quite a high caliber. It still do some damage. I've had trouble with them against medium tanks, especially against weak spots, any flat areas on the German tanks when it hits. It's also got a good reload speed, and its range is, I believe, 190. Yes. So the Russian, but the Russian AT guns, they're a bit, they do look a bit crude, as you can see there. We've knackered the turret on the tank. He's gone droopy. But yeah, it's a good gun. It's got good high explosive rounds as well. That's a lot of the Russian guns also have very good high explosive rounds. Obviously, if you've been watching my Conquest Enhancers, you'll see how deadly these can be. And the gun shield on the Russian ones, in my opinion, is better. It's a bit, gives a bit of a bigger target, but for small arms, it makes them quite difficult to shoot the infantry. And then we have the 100mm. Whew, this thing's a big lad. Now, it's not as strong as the 8.8, but it has max penetration 215, then 203, then 187, then 164, but it has armor piercing, high explosive, and armor hit piercing, high explosive, blast cap, and high explosive, but it is a powerful gun. They're very effective against things like tigers. I've even had them damage king tigers, all the heavy armor they can deal with. But the same principle comes as with the 8.8cm from the Germans. It's a massive gun, and if you need a gun this heavy at that point, bring an IS-2, bring an SU-100, you know, bring it on a mobile chassis, because even though it's good, it's a big target. Now, it does have one advantage over the German gun. It is lower, even though if we just, let's just bring it next to it so you can actually see. Let's bring them both up so we can actually see them both together. And as you can see, if you just look, it may seem a bit different, but the German one's definitely higher. This one's a bit wider, but it does make a difference when you're looking for them. But they're both quite big guns, quite easy to kill. And if you get a high explosive round near them, you'll decrew them quite quick because the infantry are always squishy. But still, it's useful if you want a really heavy gun, but I'd personally bring the SU-100 or the IS-2 or IS-1 for those bigger kind of high explosive guns that will be able to take on heavy German and Finnish armour. So next we've got the Finns. The Finns guns are a bit different. Now, the Finns have loads of different artillery and AT guns. So we've just got the AT guns here. They all look, some of them do look a bit strange, the Finnish guns. They've got very weird designs, looking literally like they've bolted a bit of tin on it. But they are quite effective, some of them. So we'll start with the light stuff. A lot of it's just rehashed German equipment. So we've got 37mm PSTK, which has a range, I believe, of 160. Oh, I forgot to do the range of the 100mm. I apologise. I'll just go back. I think it's 210. No, it's 220. So it's got good range, like the 8.8. So very powerful, very long range. So 3.7cm has got a range of 160, I believe, yep. It has penetration rates of 64mm, then 56, then 47, then 35, so it's better than the 37mm from the Germans. Has a good little fire rate on it, has armor piercing, high explosive rounds. It's only four light tanks though, and dealing with light infantry, but it can knock off little bits of the shield skirts. But yeah, it's not really an AT gun to rely on, just bring it if you're really desperate, but you're better off upgrading to the bigger stuff. Next we've got the 47mm, same as the German one, but it's a bit different because the Finns, it's got 170 range. It's got penetration rates of 50, 59, 54, 50, and 44. So that is lower than the German one by quite considerably. So it's still quite a light gun. Decent firing, but this will only be dealing with light armor as well. Won't do much against medium, as you can see. Nice little bounce there. Ding. But does have high explosive rounds. Comes with quite a lot of ammunition, but I'd avoid that one as well. And also, this one has no gun shield at all, which means they're very, very, very vulnerable to small arms. Next, you've got the 50 PSTK, which is a lot better than the other one. This has 102mm pen, 92 then, 76, then 64. Comes with armor-piercing, high-explosive, and then armor-piercing, composite rigid. This can deal with T-34s, as you can see. Certain areas, not all of it, but especially the turrets it can, if you hit, try and get around him. It's quite a good gun, decent reload speed, quite powerful, but it does help if you actually hit the target. But yeah, it's not as accurate as some of the bigger guns. Let's try and get the turret. So not getting much luck there, but it can penetrate the tanks. Let's put a composite rigid in just to see if that will go through it. It will normally on the turret. Nah, can't get the turret, it seems. I'm quite determined to do it. There we go. But that will normally injure the crew. It's not bad. I tend to use them against light tanks, infantry, and then against medium tanks I try and hit the side more than anything. But it's not a bad little gun. It's definitely your first AT gun you can kind of rely on, but it's still nothing compared to the 7.5 centimeters, and the range on that is 180, I believe. Yeah, just shy of 180. Next, we've got this is another one of the French converted guns. It's the 75 PSTK 9738, and it's got those high explosive anti-tank rounds. Has a range of just shy of 170, so it's a 170 range. And as you can see, it's got these high explosive anti-tank rounds, and if it actually hits with them, it's just like the German one, quite powerful. But I'm not having much luck with the Finnish weapon teams. There we go, got a hit. Did some damage. Not a bad gun. Same as the German one, really. A lot of the weapons are very similar to the Germans. Next, we've got the 75K, which has... the penetration on this is 88mm. Apologies. Now, the range on this is, I believe, about 200. Yep. It has... 75K has the K40. It's 150, then 142, then 133, then 119. So it's the same as the PAC-40, basically. It's very powerful. We'll deal, as you can see, we'll definitely deal with medium tanks. Whoa, took his turret right off. It's got decent fire rate. It comes with all different rounds. Comes with the armor-piercing, high-explosive, composite rigid, and high-explosive anti-tank. So this is, once again, your best multi-role gun. It's pretty much the same as the PAC-40, as I said. So great little gun for the Finns, or big gun, shall I say. And if you need some reliable anti-tank, bring that, especially for the Finns, because they don't get much decent armor. So they're more reliant on their AT guns than most factions. Then you got this weird-ass thing, because it looks like the most weird kind of Robot Wars-looking gun ever. Just going to spin round, sorry. Look at that thing, it is just ugly. It literally has got eyes and a nose. It's a terrible-looking thing. Now this is 75K44. It's obviously the late-stage pack that the Finns made. It is powerful. It's got penetration range of 182mm, then 172, 160, then 144. And I believe it has range of about 200-ish, 220, 210. Yeah, 210. Comes with high armor-piercing, high-explosive, and high-explosive anti-tank. It's very powerful, as we can demonstrate here. It's got a lot of power, and the high-explosive rounds are also powerful as well, if you need them. It's a good gun. It's very low, actually, which is quite good. So for one of the more, because even though it's not as powerful as the bigger guns, it's powerful than things like the 76 and the 7.5 there and the 7.5 here. So it's kind of like a cross between a PAC-40 and an 88 or something, because it's got that higher penetration rates, but it's quite small. So I would say I actually like this as a heavier gun, and it's very effective. It will destroy most things. Maybe not King Tiger, maybe struggle against an IS-2, but if you do really need some really powerful anti-tank, bring this thing. And it's got good range, and it's fairly cost effective, actually. But it's just a very weird looking gun. I always look at it and just think someone made that in a shed. Anyway, that's the AT guns. Like I say, normally the mid-range guns for all the factions are the best ones. The small ones lack power but have fire rate, and the big ones, especially for the Germans and the Russians, just don't, in my opinion, aren't effective for the cost. They're too big, too easy targets to hit. Anyway, I hope you found the video useful. Tell me what you think about the guns as well. And, yep, I hope everyone has a great day, and I'll see you on the next one.